Hey everyone, it's Alyce, and I'm here today for my August book haul. So we are completely shrugging off the idea that we were going to be unhauling a book for every book we hauled this year because it has gone vastly wrong. I'm going to try to do a big unhaul towards the end of the year. We do have a new bookcase that Sean has built, so we do have more space for books, but we're still acquiring books at a ridiculous speed, and it wasn't until I put them all on the table and sorted them out into piles this morning that I really kind of realised that. So I'm going to run you through this book haul, and it's going to be quite a large one again. When aren't our book hauls large? But hopefully, she says with the most optimism that she's ever had, we will haul less books in September, so next month's book haul will be a much smaller one. So as normal, we're going to start off with the books that you may have already seen if you watch this channel regularly. So these are the books that we have unboxed and hauled over the last couple of weeks. So if you've already seen any of these videos, I'll just run through them pretty quickly. But if you'd like to see these books in more detail, then the videos are out there for you. So this month we hauled the Butcher Boucher versions of Strange the Dreamer and Muse of Nightmares by Lainey Taylor. So these are German editions that have this absolutely gorgeous stenciled edge design that lines up. And they are very, very beautiful. The first German books that I have owned, but definitely not the last, because I do already have some other ones that are on pre-order and will be arriving soon. We also have the Fairyloot editions of the Ark of Scythe series by Neil Schusterman. So these involve Scythe, Thunderhead, and the Toll. These are absolutely stunning editions that line up really, really nicely. They've got alternate covers under the dust jackets, and the first one is signed and the rest have digital signatures. So very, very beautiful books, looking great on my shelf, and one of my favourite series, so it's nice to have some special editions of those. We also have the next three books in the From Blood and Ash series from Illumicrate, which are A Kingdom of Flesh and Fire, The Crown of Gilded Bones, and The War of Two Queens. These have the stenciled sprayed edges and match the first book that Illumicrate did last year, or possibly the year before. I can't remember the order that these go in, so I got that wrong in the video, and I'm pretty sure I've gotten that wrong again now. But I will read these eventually, and then I will know what order they go in. But until now, they are just beautiful and look nice on my shelf. And last but not least, for books that you might have already seen, we have the three books that were featured in August's Book Box Battle episode. So we have Violet Maid of Thorns by Gina Chen. This came in a Fairyloot box and has these absolutely gorgeous ombre sprayed edges. We have The Drowned Woods by Emily Lloyd-Jones, which came in Owlcrate last month. And we also have the absolutely gorgeous version of Babel by Illumicrate. This is by RF Kwong, and this comes with a slipcase and a redesigned cover, as well as some stenciled quote on the edges. So I think it's time for us to move on to hauling some new books that you haven't seen yet. So I'm actually going to do an unboxing to start with, because the book arrived yesterday and I haven't had time to open it yet, but it is another special edition, so I'll just grab that for you. And as you can see, it is a Fairyloot edition, so let me just whip this one open and then we can see how pretty it is together. And this is in bubble wrap instead of in a little Fairyloot pouch, which is surprising. And it is the Fairyloot exclusive edition of Empress Crowned in Red by Shannon Smart. This is the sequel to Which is Steeped in Gold, and I didn't love the first book, but I was interested enough to carry on with the series, and I really liked the Fairyloot designs on these, so decided to order the sequel. And this again has the completely redesigned cover, has the stenciled sprayed edges with this kind of eye pattern on them, and it's signed, and also has foiling under the dust jacket and under the dust jacket artwork with the characters on there. So we will do what we normally do, we'll get all the details on the screen about the illustrator of the under the dust jacket artwork, because that isn't mentioned on the order card. But I'm glad that I ordered this one. I hope that I enjoyed the sequel more than I enjoyed the first book, but it will certainly look gorgeous on my shelf. And last but not least, the last full price book that I purchased in August was Her Majesty's Royal Coven by Juno Dawson. I actually paid for this in the middle of July, but Waterstones have been having some problems with their ordering system because they've done a big upgrade and everything got very delayed, so I only managed to pick this up about a week ago. But this is the Waterstones exclusive with the yellow sprayed edges, which looks so nice and beautifully vibrant with the author's name on the cover, and it's also signed. So I think I like this one more than the Fairy Loot edition. I do like the Fairy Loot edition because it has Under the Dust Jacket foiling. I'll link the unboxing that we did for that one because that was back in July. But yes, very happy to have another copy of this one because this is the copy that I ordered the day that the book got announced, before I realised that Fairy Loot were going to be doing it in the adult book only box. But I've heard from my friend who has read it that it is amazing and that it's one of his favourite books of the year, so hopefully I'll enjoy it just as much when I read it next week. So now we're going to move on to some books that I have managed to purchase through Facebook, because I've been on a bit of a Facebook marketplace kick, and I probably shouldn't have been because it's dangerous, because I'm buying some special editions and some books that I've been interested in for a long time that I just haven't managed to acquire yet. So I'll just grab those and then we can go through those as quickly as possible. So all from the same seller, I bought the Girl of Fire and Thorns series by Rae Carson, which includes The Girl of Fire and Thorns, The Crown of Embers, and The Bitter Kingdom. I've been interested in these in a very long time, but as far as I'm aware, they were never published in the UK because these are US editions. But I've had this on my Goodreads want to read list since I heard about it back in like 2012. When did it come out? 2011. So yeah, I've been interested in these in a while. Hopefully I will enjoy them when I get to them. And I also got the entire, apart from I think there's one short story collection that I'm missing, but the entire Dorothy Must Die series by Danielle Page. I did not enjoy Danielle Page's Stealing Snow series. I thought that it was one of the worst things that I'd ever read, but I had Dorothy Must Die. I have a copy of this at my parents' house somewhere, but I didn't own any of the others. And again, as far as I'm aware, didn't get published in the UK because these are all US editions. So, to find them quite cheap on Facebook in brilliant condition and to have short story collections which I didn't even know existed in the bundle, I was very happy with that. So I'll keep an eye out for the last short story collection and get to these at some point. I do really like fairy tale retellings, so I think that this one is going to be fun. I heard a lot of hype on BookTube, like the OG BookTubers like Jessie and Poland Banana Books. I'm pretty sure they all loved this back when it first came out. So hopefully I will enjoy them too. But these are Dorothy Must Die, The End of Oz, I'm going to be doing all these in the wrong order, The Wicked Will Rise, Yellow Brick Road, and Dorothy Must Die Stories, and Dorothy Must Die Stories Volume 2. But as far as I'm aware, there's also a Volume 3 of the stories, so I'll keep an eye out for that at some point. And yeah, nice little stack to haul. Also through Facebook, I managed to get two book box books, which are Shielded and The Hollow Heart. Shielded by Kaylin Flanders and The Hollow Heart by Marie Rutkowski. So Shielded is a fairy book. It was the only one in quite a long stretch that I was missing, and this was £10 on Facebook, so I was happy to pay that for it. And this is signed and has the black sprayed edges. Doesn't have anything under the dust jacket as far as I'm aware. Oh, it has like a little symbol on the hardcover case. And then The Hollow Heart by Marie Rutkowski is actually an Illumicrate book. This is the sequel to The Midnight Lie. I have the Fairy Loot duology of this, but the Illumicrate version of this book is actually still available on their website for like £20, and this was only £10, so that is a bargain, and it means I've got two matching sets, so if I love it I can keep them both, and if I don't love it then I can find somebody who does and pass them on to them. This has gorgeous pinky purpley sprayed edges. It is signed and it has nothing else about it that is notable apart from the exclusive redesigned cover, which is absolutely stunning. Like, I just love this color scheme a lot more because the UK covers I'm pretty sure have like an autumnal cover scheme. They're quite yellowy orangey, and like purple is my favorite color, so I am a sucker for these designs. So we will then move on from the books that I bought new and full priced and the Facebook books, and we will go to books that I acquired for free this month. And as you can see, they're quite big towers, and I probably should just stop going to the free bookshops and going to the free book boxes. But it's a good opportunity to cycle out some of the books that we are getting rid of, and it's a good opportunity to just have like a little fun trip with the family, because the kids often find books that they're really interested in, and then I grab some for myself too. But we will dive in to these. So we'll start off with a little stack of books by David Eddings. I hauled a David Eddings book a couple of months ago, was really, really interested in it, haven't had a chance to get to it yet, but I found Porn of Prophecy, which is book one of the Belgariad series. Haven't heard of it, but it's book one in a series and it's quite skinny, so I can give that a go. And I also managed to haul the entire Elenium trilogy. So this is The Diamond Throne, The Ruby Knight and The Sapphire Rose. They sound very, very interesting. I'm very interested in David Eddings' writing, as I've mentioned, and if I don't enjoy them, I think that my friend really will, because he likes kind of classic fantasy, likes those kind of books a lot. So I have somebody that I can pass these on to if I don't enjoy them, or I can just return them to the book box and see if anything else is in there. So it's a win-win situation. I then have three books that I grabbed for the kids from the book boxes, which are Dog at the Door, Foxes on the Farm, and Seals on the Sled by Lucy Daniels. And these are all part of the Animal Ark series. This was a series that I really treasured when I was younger, so we've been slowly but surely gathering them up to pass on to the kids. You will not be able to see, but we have like a little stack of them over there. And now we have a few more to add. Sophia really loves the covers and likes flicking through them at the moment because they have some little illustrations, but she's not really at the stage where she can focus on the story. But I don't think it's going to be too long, and these will be nice bedtime stories, so we can just do a couple of chapters and then pick it up the next night. There was also a person who had advertised that they had left books outside of their house free on Facebook, and we went along because they had a huge stack of Goosebumps books. And by the time we got there were only two left, but we didn't have either of these. So these are Goosebumps, the movie novel, and Goosebumps Vampire Breath, both by R.L. Stine. Or I think this one is just inspired by R.L. Stine, probably not actually written by him. But Sean and I both really loved the Goosebumps books when we were younger. Again, they're ones that we want to pass on to the kids. Again, the kids like flicking through them at the moment, but they're not all that actively interested in the stories. But these will be great for bedtime reading as well. And then we also have some books that are kind of for the kids and are kind of for me, because I really love Tom Fletcher. I think that his writing's really great. I think that he's a great guy. And they were giving away The Christmas Thesaurus and The Crinkers free. And The Crinkers is actually a signed copy. And it was free, which is just so cool. I have the musical edition of the Christmas Thesaurus book, but it's a signed copy, so I haven't read it yet. So this is an unsigned one that the kids and I can just absolutely beat to death. They have really cute end papers, like photographs of the characters and maps and things, which is really sweet. And also has a little foil stamp under the dust jacket on the hardcover, which is very cute. And that's exactly the same on the Creakers as well. You've got a bunch of artwork of the characters and the little foil on the hardcover. So they're just really nice little additions. And for free, especially for a signed book, I'm not going to say no. And I also grabbed one that was purely for myself, which is To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. I read this out of the library and then I bought books 2 and 3, loved book 2, never got to book 3 because I wanted to reread the first 2 because it was quite a while before the third one came out. This has a Paw Patrol playing card in it, so I'm guessing that means my kids have been playing with this book while I've been at work, which is very cute. Apparently they got to chapter 4. But yes, always wanted to get a copy of the first one, and I've only ever seen it in the movie tie-in edition, but this matches my editions, so I'm happy with this one. I then have A Proof of Children of Blood and Bone by Tomi Adeyemi, which I wasn't expecting to spot in the free book shop, but I'm actually wondering if I may have unhauled my proof by accident, because I do have a finished paperback of this one that has the maps and everything in it, and I had been considering unhauling one of them after I read it. I haven't read it yet, but my copy is no longer where I thought it was, and I can't find it anywhere, so I grabbed this one when I saw it, because I couldn't remember where mine was, and now I'm wondering if it actually was my one and I just did a doofus, or if Sean might have grabbed like a bag of books to donate and hadn't realised that this had been put in the top accidentally, anything like that, because it's somewhere where we donate books quite regularly. But I have it now, and if I find that I have another copy, I will be giving this one away or passing it on to a friend who I think will love it, or seeing if anybody is in need of it, like desperately in search of on books for trade or anything like that, so that I can give somebody their unicorn. But just holding on to it for now, just in case, and hoping to read that one soon. I also have Running with the Demon by Terry Brooks. This is the first book in the Word and the Void series. Not a series of Terry Brooks that I've heard of, but I've got some of his other books and my friend keeps recommending them to me because he writes the Shannara books, and I haven't read any of them yet, but this one was free and it was the first in a series, so I grabbed it. I have no self-control, we've learnt this, you've been here before. We then have The Mystery of the Jeweled Moth by Catherine Woodfine. I have the first book in this series, but I have not read it yet, and I never managed to get hold of any of the others, so to find this one for free in a book box was very exciting. I've heard that these are basically like Murder Most Unladylike, but I think 10, 20 years later. I'll need to have... Or maybe it's earlier. Maybe these are like the Victorian equivalent. But they sound very interesting. They're middle grade mysteries and I like middle grade mysteries, so of course I had to pick it up. And also these covers are just stunning. Like, such nice designs on those. We also have Sweet Evil and Sweet Peril by Wendy Higgins. This is another one that I have had on my Goodreads Want to Read list and on my Amazon wishlist for so freaking long, but I don't think it was ever published in the UK because these are US editions, but I managed to find them free in the local free bookshop, so I grabbed them. These have been out since 2012. And, like, I'd heard of this one, just the first one was out, and I wanted to read it. So I've been waiting to read these for a while. Haven't managed to get hold of the third one yet, but hopefully I will read these and enjoy them. Because, I'll be honest, I'm still interested in paranormal YA romance. I just haven't found ones that I absolutely love. But I'm hoping, based off the fact that these are really hyped at the time, that I might enjoy them. We have some more middle grade books, which are Swarm Rising by Tim Peake. This is a hardcover and has like a funky design underneath with binary code. That's very cool. I haven't heard much about it, but Sean likes Tim Peake and I like middle grade, so it was a good one to grab. And then Sean, bless his sweet, sweet little soul, managed to get Knock Three Times and Never and Forever by Cressida Cowell. These are books 3 and 4 in the Wizards of Once series, and Sean actually got me Never and Forever for Christmas last year and completely forgot. So we now have two copies of this one. My copy is signed, this copy isn't, so we will probably read this one so that I won't be worried about damaging it, and then we will see if we can find somebody to pass it on to. But it was just very sweet that he was like, I know you've been interested in these, and I'm like, yeah, I was so interested that you bought me book 4 when I didn't own any of the others. Which is very sweet of him. But it's nice to have a hardcover of book 3 to match book 4. So now we've just got to look out for hardcovers of books 1 and 2. And then the last little stack of free books includes Night Watch by Terry Pratchett. Sean wants to read all of the Discworld books eventually, and we have been kind of grabbing them as we go. And this one was free, and one that neither of us could remember having on our shelves already, so we picked it up. He also picked up The Winter King by Bernard Cornwell, which is an Arthurian retelling. I think this is the first in a series, or the third in a series. It's the first in a series. Of which I've got a feeling he might have the third one because he bought it thinking it was a standalone. Now he has the first one, but we're just going to have to keep an eye out to see if we can find the second one anywhere. Who knows? We also got 2 Stephen King books because we eventually want to own all of Stephen King's books. We got The Stand by Stephen King, which we have a very, very beaten up hardback of, which we found through last year. But this is a really sexy edition, actually. It's not an edition I've ever seen before. But it's very, very gorgeous. I can't imagine how well the binding is going to hold up while we're actually reading it, because this is a paperback which is over 1,300 pages, which is a chunker, but it's a nice edition. And we also got Pet Sematary, and these are in the cover styles that we normally like to collect, so that was a very lucky find because we didn't own Pet Sematary at all, and now we have it for free. And last but not least, we managed to get Shuggy Bane by Douglas Stewart, which won the Man Booker Prize in 2020. I'm interested in Man Booker Prizes and shortlists and winners, and I just don't feel like I'm quite smart enough to read some of them. But I've heard very good things about Shuggy Bane, so I grabbed it when I saw it, and hopefully we will actually get to it, because it would be nice to read a bit more literary fiction and branch out a bit more. We then have a stack of books that we hold at the Lib called Jumble Trails. So if you haven't heard of Jumble Trails, what the concept is it's like a jumble sale, but everybody does it on their driveway, and then you walk around the neighbourhood and you go to different people's houses. And we've done a couple in the last month. We've got a couple coming up in September, and then they kind of stop over the winter period because it's too wet outside. Understandably, we are in England. So we've done a couple, got some books from them, but mostly we just kind of have a day out with the kids and wander around and get them some little bits and pieces of toys. So not too many in this stack, but also probably more than there should be. So all from the same lady, we managed to get like a really nice little sci-fi fantasy haul. So we got Skyward by Brandon Sanderson, which was a steal. All of these together, including a bunch of stuff, like we got some Christmas presents for the kids, we got a Christmas present for Grandad, and I think all together it came to £10. And I would have happily paid that just for this hardcover because I really like this edition. You've got the end papers have like the desolate planet. And I have the third book in hardcover because I found it in a charity shop like a couple months after it came out. So now I've got the first one. Just need to try and get the second one, and then I've got them all matching. And we also have from Karen Miller's Fisherman's Children series, we have The Prodigal Mage and The Reluctant Mage, which are books 1 and 2 in that series. And we also have A Blight of Mages, which I don't know if it's the third one, because it does seem, well, it also says The Innocent Mage is one of them, so I don't know whether there's a couple of series, because The Innocent Mage is apparently Karen Miller's debut, and that's none of these. But this is set in the same world, so I think you can kind of read it by itself if you want to. Yeah, these are the only two books that are coming up for the Fisherman's Children series in this book, so I think those are all in order. But I've heard people recommend Karen Miller's writing, and again, they were very, very cheap because we were buying lots and lots of things. And we also got two books by James Barclay, which are Night Child and Dawn Thief. And I've heard of James Barclay. Sean was more interested in these ones than I was, I think because there's big swords on the cover. He's always interested in books with swords on the covers. But then this one has like a wolf and a lady yelling and some tiny children. So I'm interested in this. I'm wondering if it might be Changelings or some kind of story like that. But yeah, it'll be nice to try a new author, and again, pretty cheap for a very big old stack of books. And then we also found, I'm trying to work out the best order to do this in, we will rearrange. We also found a seller who was selling brand new books, £3 for £5. I don't know whether they worked with the book people or if they'd had them donated by like a local organisation, but I managed to get 2 books for my mum and 4 books for myself. So I got The Devil You Know by Emma Kavanagh. I think this one may have been a mistake, because I did read The Killer at the Wall, I think it was called, by Emma Kavanagh last year, and I hated it. The plot of this one sounds really good. To catch a killer, she must think like one. She's a smart, good girl. Thinks she has herself all figured out, and then there's an intruder, but he's looking for somebody else, and that sounds really interesting. So I got it. I'll give her another go. I also got The Last Wife by Karen Hamilton. I read Karen Hamilton's The Perfect Girlfriend, and I thought it was one hell of a ride. Like, it was a bit slow to start with, but then I read the second half in a night and I literally could not put it down. I was up until like 4 in the morning reading this stupid book that just made no sense and was absolutely insane, but I loved it. So definitely happy to read another Karen Hamilton book. I also picked up The July Girls by Phoebe Locke, which I haven't heard of, but it says, on a hot summer's night, another girl is taken. Every year on the same night, another woman disappears without a trace. Ooh. So, someone's wife is missing, and then someone's dad comes home covered in blood. So, it's a case that I think the dad is probably the one that's taking the missing women. So, it'll be interesting to see if these two characters kind of come together to solve this mystery. But that's the kind of book that I like the premise of, and it's never worked for me. So, this one might, I hope, because it sounds really, really good. And then last but not least, from that same seller, I managed to get Harrow Lake by Kat Ellis in the Sprayed Yellow Pages edition. I hauled a proof of Harrow Lake a couple months ago that I found in a charity shop, but I couldn't resist getting another copy of it because I really liked Kat Ellis's second book. Haven't had a chance to read Harrow Lake yet. I can't remember what her second book is even called, so I will ask Sean if he can put that up on the screen, because I can picture, like, the girl running away, like, down the corridor, but I have no idea. But I wanted to grab this in case I love it as much as I liked that second book, whose name I can't even remember. I will say it was, like, This Wicked Fate or something like that, but I'm probably completely making that up. Who knows? And then we also have three more books. So we got Autopsy by Patricia Cornwell. This is the most recent Kay Scarpetta book that has been released, and this was the only one that I didn't own, because Patricia Cornwell did a break of, I think, 6 years between Kay Scarpetta novels. I haven't caught up yet, but I think Sean said that he got this for me for like 50 pence or a pound. So for a hardback that only came out in either November or December, I'm not gonna say no. We also got Stephen King's Revival. As I've already mentioned, we're trying to collect all of the Stephen King books so that we can read them all eventually, and this was one that we didn't have, and the person was selling it for, I think, 20p. I've got a feeling that kids' books were 10p and adult books were 20p. So the same person I also bought Underbelly by Anna Whitehouse from. Haven't heard of it, but it looks very, very interesting. She doesn't want your life, she wants to destroy it. Tell me that doesn't look like a really freaking intense story. And the person who was selling it said that she really, really enjoyed it and it was a great book. So I thought I would trust her recommendation. For 20 pence, can you really go wrong? Last but not least, well, before the Kindle books, we will move on to the books that we have acquired from charity shops this month, because it just keeps going. Like, this haul is just never ending. But then we've also got, I think, 5 Kindle books for you, and then I will let you go on with your day. So, charity shops. Someone's ringing the bell. I'll go answer that. Thought that might have been post, but it was just my neighbours who I had to go and help instead. So now I am back with you, and we will finally go on with the charity shop books. So we actually have 4 that I missed off of last month's haul, which was embarrassing because I found them basically as soon as we'd finished filming. And those are Before She Knew Him by Peter Swanson. I really enjoyed Peter Swanson's The Kind Worth Killing, and I'm always happy to grab another Peter Swanson book, so thought I'd give this one a go. We have Ship of Magic and Royal Assassin by Robin Harbour, which are £1.25 each, and they're in these gorgeous tiny little paperbacks with the kind of foiled covers. These are the editions I would ideally like to collect, but we're just kind of grabbing what we can when we can. Didn't have either of these yet, as far as we could remember, but now we do. We have them both, which is great. And I also got, ironically enough, Spark Joy by Marie Kondo, an illustrated guide to the Japanese art of tidying. As you can tell, I'm a bit of a hoarder. I like to collect things, and Sean is also very bad at tidying, so even if I leave it so that it's kind of organised chaos, Sean will just turn it into straight up crazy chaos. So I'm hoping that reading this together might help give him some ideas and make us both more aware of what we're acquiring, how we're acquiring it, and what kind of things we should look at downsizing. Probably books. But I have read this before and I really enjoyed it. I like Marie Kondo, so thought I would grab it because it was pretty cheap. We then have Malibu Rising by Taylor Jenkins Reid. This is the WH Smith exclusive edition, so I think it has some bonus content in it. But I had the ebook of it, didn't have the physical copy, and I thought I might as well grab it because it was only £2. And we also got The Thursday Murder Club by Richard Osman. We have a hardcover of this, which is missing the dust jacket because it was ripped when we got it out with the book box. And this was only £2, but this is the Waterstones exclusive edition, including a special outtake chapter, and it has red sprayed pages, which is very cute. I also picked up The Plague Charmer by Karen Maitland. I've bought a couple of Karen Maitland's books in the past, but I haven't had a chance to read any of them yet, but I am really interested in her writing, because she writes extremely historical books set in, like, the 1200s, 1300s, based around the plague and the Black Death, things like that, and they sound like they're going to be right up my alley when I get to them, and this one just has a very interesting cover, so I picked that up. Also got The Book of Sand by Mo Hayder, writing as Theo Clare. I was interested in this one when it came out, but they only had like the hard covers in Waterstones with like the stenciled edges, and it was quite expensive for one that I wasn't really all that interested in. But this is a completely flawless unread edition, and this was only £2 in the charity shop, so it was well worth picking up. We also had The Party Crasher by Sophie Kinsella. Sean and I both really enjoy Sophie Kinsella's writing, and we're trying to collect all of her books in these editions, and this is a new one that's just come out, I think, because I haven't heard of it before. Yeah, it came out in 2021, so we picked that one up as well. We also have Trisha Sullivan's Dreaming in Smoke. Haven't heard of it or the author, but Sean collects the Sci-Fi Masterworks series, so this was another one for him to have. We also found Eyes of the Void by Adrian Tchaikovsky, and this is a signed copy. And this only came out this year, I think. Yes, a 2022 release. So we don't have the first book in the series, but we are interested in Adrian Tchaikovsky's Children of Time series, and we own the first one in that series. So what we're going to do is we're going to read that one, and then if we enjoy it, we'll carry on with that series, and then we'll buy the first one in this series and hopefully enjoy it too. Only four more to go, we're nearly there. Sean picked up Journey to the Centre of the Earth by Jules Verne in this cute little orange penguin science fiction edition. We do have... No, we don't. We've got 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, but we didn't have Journey to the Centre of the Earth, which is why Sean picked this one up. I picked up Ash Princess by Laura Sebastian because it's got the really cool cover with like the cutout crown and the fire underneath, which is a lot of fun, and it was only 50p. That speaks for itself. We also picked up Islands of Abandonment by Cal Flynn. This is about the way that places which have been abandoned are kind of reclaimed by nature, and how things might be after humanity ceases. And this just really, really interests me. This is the kind of concept that just really plays on my mind quite a lot. And I didn't know that this book existed. Spotted it in the charity shop window and I couldn't stop thinking about it for a few days. So I went back and luckily it was still there. So I'm going to be picking this one up very soon, and I'm very interested in it, especially because it's also got photography. So it'd be nice to see kind of the places that are mentioned and actually see them. And last but not least, we have The Obelisk Gate by N.K. Jemisin. This is the second book in the Broken Earth series. So I have the fifth season on my Kindle, didn't own any of the others, but spotted this one in the charity shop, so we picked this one up as well, and then hopefully we will be able to get through these and find the third book in the series too. So now I will just quickly run to Amazon and see what we hauled on our Kindle this month. So we hauled Wondersmith by Jessica Townsend. That is the second book in the Nevermore series. They put Nevermore down to 99p in July, and then they put Wondersmith down in August. So we've got the first two books now, we'll be able to reread them. Hopefully they will put Hollowpox down soon, and then we can reread that too, getting ready for Silverborn, which has been pushed back to next October, not this October, and I'm still not happy about that, but fine, it is what it is. I also got, I can't remember, I'm going to just have to get my phone, aren't I? Why am I like this? I also hauled The Henna Wars by Adiba Jaygerda. Adiba recently won the YA Book Prize with Honey and Issue's Guide to Fake Dating, and I was really interested in reading her other work, and The Henna Wars went down a few days before she won, actually, and it went down to 99p, and it's one I'm super duper interested in because it sounds like these two girls have rival henna businesses, and then it's an enemies to lovers relationship, but it's also sapphic, so I am 100% here for that. And now I'm gonna pause so that I can go and get my phone, because I just can't remember the other three. There was Delilah Green Doesn't Care, but I can't remember what the author's name is, and I can't remember who wrote Zodiac Academy either. I'm useless. So also on my Kindle this month, I hauled The Secrets of the Storm Forest by L.D. Lipinski. This is the third book in the Strange Worlds Travel Agency series, which I still haven't read. I still haven't started, but I'm sure I'm going to love it because it's about characters who go into like these magical suitcases and they get transported to other worlds. It sounds like exactly my kind of middle grade. I just haven't started the series yet, which I don't know why, but soon. So I'm just hoarding these up ready for the future. I also have Delilah Green Doesn't Care by Ashley Herring Blake. I've heard of some of Ashley Herring Blake's middle grade and YA novels, but this is their first adult novel. And I know for a fact that it was featured in the Illumicrae, what's it called? Afterlight? Is that the romance subscription name? We'll say that it is. But it was featured in one of their boxes, and I normally like trust the recommendations of a Luma Crate because I've been subscribed to them for a very long time. So if they recommend that as a good example of an adult romance, then I'm going to get it. And it's also sapphic, so I'm here for that. And last but not least, I hauled Zodiac Academy The Awakening by Caroline Peckham and Suzanne Valenti. So this is the first book in the Zodiac Academy series. I don't know much about the series. I just know literally everybody goes on about it on Facebook, on BookBox Sherlock's and on some of the buy-sell trade groups. They're always in search of special editions of this series. I don't know if it's Bookish Box, maybe, has recently done special editions of these. I will see if I can find that out and get it somewhere on the screen here. But I caved. They've put the later ones in the series down over the last few months and I haven't caved because I didn't own the first one, and then the first one went down to 99p and I caved hard. I don't know if I'm gonna like it. I don't know what to expect from it. It's kind of, it sounds like it's gonna be a school YA, but then I've heard a lot of people say that it's smutty, so I don't know if it's meant to be like a uni but magical. And I have not the foggiest, but it was 99p, so I could justify picking it up. Because I'm a mess. What don't I buy? So let's find out how many books we hauled this month, because at the moment I think it's going to be more than I want it to be, because I can see the encroaching stacks on my table. I will go and do some counting. 82 books. 82 books in one fucking month. I know August is a long month. I know four of those books I forgot to haul from last month, so that means technically it was 78, but that's still too many. I know most of these were free, but it's still too many. It doesn't matter how much they cost if I don't have space for them. It doesn't help that Scythe and From Blood and Ash arrived at the same time, because obviously those are like, that's six books straight off, and that's two sets that I ordered very, very far apart. But it's too many. So I'm going to challenge myself, apart from obviously the ones I've already pre-ordered, I'm going to challenge myself to haul less than 10 books in September. I'm not including pre-orders that are arriving, because I'm not going to cancel anything this late in the game, because that would be wild and wacky. That would not go well. But yes, less than 10 books in September. Check back at the end of September and see if that happens, because maybe that will be easier for me to stick to rather than thinking, oh, I'll unhaul a book for every book I haul, because then I was just trying to randomly get rid of shit that I was still kind of interested in, and then I hung on to it even though I'd said that I'd unhauled it because I was panicking about getting rid of it, and that's not a good way to be. So we're gonna try 10 books max in September, and hopefully I'll also start working through some of my backlist and maybe see if I can unhaul some, because it would be good to be in a position where we were like reading physical books and getting rid of them rather than just constantly reading on my Kindle, because what am I doing hauling this many physical books if I'm mostly just reading ebooks? I am a mistake. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you'd like to subscribe, we'd be super duper grateful. We are ridiculously close to 1,000 subscribers, which is, I didn't think I would ever get anywhere close to that milestone, and I didn't think I would be saying it. It just feels very bizarre. So thank you all for your support. Please let me know which books you think I should start with out of everything that I hauled in this video. Please let me know if you think that there's anything that should just be straight back out the door. Like, if you've read it and you hated it, let me know. Tell me if I made mistakes with my acquiring, because I'm really feeling like a mistake right now. I'm Alyce. This is the Bumbling Blogger, and we will see you in a few days with another video. Thank you for watching. Bye! 82 fucking books? Oh man. So we have 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. No. 82 books.